Hi, it's Trevor from Plateau Astro. I'm recording this in early October, just a few days into autumn, and it's getting really noticeable now that the sun is setting earlier and earlier. And of course, during the winter, the sun will set here quite early. I grew up in central Alberta, just outside of Edmonton, and there, during the winter, the sun would set very early, just around the time I was coming home from school. And I was always under the impression that the more north you are, the earlier your sunsets would be. And I think most people think this is true. If we look at a map of Edmonton and Montreal, we see that Montreal is quite a bit more south. So using this logic, in winter, the more north you are, the earlier your sun sets, I should expect that Edmonton's sunset will happen earlier than Montreal's. But it's not. If you look at the sunset time on December 21st, here's the results. Montreal's, the sun sets at 4:13 p.m. And in Edmonton, 4:16 p.m. What's going on here? Why does Montreal, a city that's much further south, have an earlier sunset in the winter than Edmonton? A big factor we don't consider when thinking of our sunset time is where in the time zone we are located. Canada uses 6 time zones. Here is a map. We've got Newfoundland, Atlantic, Eastern, Central, Mountain, and Pacific. Montreal is located in the Eastern time zone, and this time zone is a little bit odd because it covers a lot of area east to west. The important thing to remember with time zones is that it's the same time everywhere in the time zone. So if it's 1 p.m. in Montreal, it's also 1 p.m. in Toronto, Iqaluit, Natashquin, everywhere in the time zone. I'm going to compare the sunset times of 2 locations in the Eastern time zone. But instead of comparing 2 locations that have drastically different north-south locations, like Edmonton and Montreal, I'm going to compare 2 locations that are about the same latitude. So I'm going to compare Perse and Thunder Bay. Now, Perse is located in the east end of the Eastern time zone, whereas Thunder Bay is located in the far west end of the Eastern time zone. But remember, they both have the same time. If it's 1 p.m. in Perse, it's also 1 p.m. in Thunder Bay. Now, it's one thing to compare these locations on a flat map, but let's see what happens when we compare them on a globe. When viewed above the North Pole, the Earth rotates counterclockwise. On the side here, I have the sun, and the part on the globe that's in light is daytime, and the part in shadow is nighttime. On the globe, I've marked out Perse and Thunder Bay. And remember, this entire region is the Eastern time zone, so it's the same time for both Perse and Thunder Bay. As the Earth rotates, Perse will fall into shadow first before Thunder Bay. So even though it's the same time in both locations, Perse is in shadow while Thunder Bay is still in light. What this means is the sun sets earlier in the eastern part of the time zone than the western part of the time zone. On December 21st in Perse, the sun sets at 3:23 p.m. and in Thunder Bay at 5:04 p.m. That's over an hour and 40 minutes difference in sunset time for 2 places that are at the same latitude. And all of that is because of their location in the time zone. But it doesn't mean that Perse gets less daylight. It just means everything happens earlier, including the sunrise. On that same day, December 21st, the sun rises in Perse at 7:08 a.m. and in Thunder Bay, 8:45 a.m. So if you're a morning person and you like early sunrises, try to live in a place that's in the eastern part of the time zone. And if you're a night owl, best to live in a place that's more west in the time zone. You could even plan out your vacation around this idea. If you want a late sunset in the summer, go to a place that's in the western part of the time zone. Or if you want early morning jogs, choose a place in the eastern area of the time zone. When you take a quick glance at the time zone map of Canada, it kind of looks like they all begin and end along the borders of the provinces. But if we zoom in, that's not always the case. If we look at the most eastern point of Quebec, we see a region which uses the Atlantic instead of the eastern time zone. Remember, the more east you are in the time zone, the earlier everything happens. So as an example, this place, Natashquan, has a sunset time of 3:06 p.m. on December 21st. But about 50 kilometers east is a town called Kagoska. But there, they use the Atlantic time zone, even though they're still part of Quebec. In nearly the same location as Natashquan, using the Atlantic time zone has a sunset time of 4:05 p.m. Here's one more. If we go to the western end of Ontario, we see a region using central daylight time. Remember, the more west you are in the time zone, the later you have your sunrises and sunsets. So by adopting central daylight time, their sunrises and sunsets aren't so late. Back to Edmonton and Montreal. Because Edmonton is located more west in their time zone, they get later sunsets than Montreal. So what does being more north in the winter actually mean then? Well, you get less total daylight. On December 21st, Montreal gets about 8 hours and 40 minutes of daylight, whereas Edmonton only gets about 7 hours and 30 minutes, about an hour less light. So while the sunset here in Montreal is a few minutes earlier than Edmonton's, the sunrise is earlier here too. Thank you to my Patreon supporters. This is Your Money at Work, me trying to make videos teaching about astronomy and how it applies to your daily life. If you're not a supporter and you want to be, go to patreon.com/plateau_astro. There's many different tier levels and you can support me for as low as $2.50 per month. If you're at the $5 per month level, I'll mail you a postcard, and I have designed these postcards myself. So if you want to help out and support me to make content like this, patreon.com/plateau_astro. Thank you very much. See you soon.